Disturbing footage has just been released of Olympic silver medalist boxer Shakur Stevenson instigating a brutal fight with a group of people, which included two women. I've got the footage and gruesome details coming up. Hey everyone, I'm Devin Howard. Have you subscribed to the Fumble yet? If not, do it now and then follow me on Instagram at Devin Howard and tap the bell for notifications. Shakur Stevenson won the silver medal for boxing at the Olympics in 2016, so he's definitely a top fighter. He knows what he's doing with his fists, but apparently he doesn't know that a boxing match is only appropriate in a ring and not in a parking garage. Yep, the 21-year-old fighter instigated a brawl at a parking garage with a group of people, including two women. This all happened last year when he was celebrating his 21st birthday in Miami along with fellow boxer David Grayton. There's no saying if alcohol played a part in the parking lot fight, but if he was out celebrating his 21st, then I'm guessing it did. So here's what went down. Stevenson and Grayton apparently made sexually explicit comments to the group of people, resulting in a violent showdown. The security tapes show Stevenson throwing a punch at a man, and in the process, he roughly hits a woman. Then Grayton approaches and beats a second woman to the floor. You can see her crumble to the ground and hit her head on an ATM machine. Another man begins to fight back against Grayton because, you know, he's attacking a girl, and Stevenson hits him from behind, sending him straight to the ground. Then the two men pummel a guy who's already on the floor. Another woman steps in and tries to get up in Grayton's face while Stevenson continues pounding the guy on the ground, sending him rolling backwards with an uppercut to the jaw. The two men then flee the scene, but they didn't escape from the scene unscathed. They were arrested for battery at their hotel, and now they have the vengeance of Twitter to deal with. People are chiming in on social media, expressing their absolute disgust that Stevenson would turn a parking garage into a boxing ring. One person wrote, "Damn, this is an Olympian and a third or sixth ranked featherweight out there risking everything being silly in the streets. Bad look for Mr. Stevenson, lost a fan here." Another wrote, "He may be undefeated, but he looks like a loser here." Someone else thinks there will be some major legal action against the two boxers. They said, "Yeah, serious lawsuits, definitely felonies." Another person wrote, "Not a good look for Shakur Stevenson. Surveillance footage showed him clocking what appeared to be a woman in the back of the head. That's classless." Most people feel the same way that I do, that he's a scumbag for assaulting anyone, let alone women. The boxer is being trolled online because of the leaked video. He tweeted out, "Anybody can get it, brother," and someone responded saying, "Even that girl you hit in the video?" This is really a bad look for the Olympic athlete. Obviously, when you're in the limelight and looked up to, as I'm sure he is, it's never a good idea to get into any sort of violent scuffle, especially a public one. Beating defenseless men, hitting women, it's all pretty terrible, and gives impressionable aspiring athletes and Olympians the wrong idea of what's okay. Fighting belongs in the ring, people, not on the streets. But what's baffling to me about all of this is that no one seems to be talking about Grayton. Sure, he isn't an Olympic medalist and doesn't have the same career that Stevenson does, but still, he was pummeling that woman to the ground and seemed to go after her more violently than Steven went after any of the women. I see a lot of people criticizing Stevenson, which, yeah, I think he absolutely deserves that, but why aren't we giving Grayton the same treatment? These guys need to go to an etiquette class, cotillion or something, because they somehow must have forgotten that A, yelling sexually explicit remarks at people is rude, B, you should never get in a fist fight ever, and C, you should never get in a fist fight ever, especially with a freaking girl. Stevenson is signed with promotional kingpin Bob Arum's company Top Rank, and I'm sure they're not loving the press he's getting right now. I wouldn't be surprised if they dropped him. The boxer is gearing up for his next fight on April 20th, and I'm not expecting him to receive a roaring applause from the crowd, that's for sure. Fumble fans, what do you think about this crazy news? Let me know in the comments, and before you go, click subscribe and don't forget to tap the bell for notifications.